Hello, and welcome to Windows 10, the Start menu, presented by the Buffalo and Erie County Public Library. On the left side of the taskbar, at the bottom of the screen, is a small Microsoft Windows icon. This icon also probably appears on your keyboard near the spacebar. Tapping this key or primary clicking on the icon will open the Start menu. The Start menu is divided into three panes, left, middle, and right. You may have noticed in a previous video that the tiles, the large square icons, in the Start menu are the ones that appear on the screen when the machine is switched to tablet mode. It is in the Start menu where these tiles can be customized or removed. Secondary clicking on each tile brings up a menu that gives me options for that app, such as resizing. If I primary click, holding the button down, I can drag tiles into new positions, then let the click go. You may have noticed that some of the tiles change appearance. These are called live tiles, and you can turn them on or off by hovering your pointer over More in the menu and then selecting the appropriate option. Note, however, that not all apps support live tiles, and so the option does not always appear. If you want to customize a live tile with your information, simply primary click on it to open the app and follow the directions to put in your settings. When you are finished, close the app by primary clicking the X in the upper right-hand corner. After a few moments, the live tile should begin updating with your information. Notice in this tutorial that I have also set up the Windows 10 Calendar app with some appointments. Using the Windows 10 Mail app for your email would also show you a summary of recent messages in your inbox, although this does not work with the paid Microsoft Outlook Office app at this time. Don't be afraid to rearrange your tiles, remove them, or make new groups. Groups can be named by clicking on the space above them, typing in whatever you want, then pressing Enter on your keyboard. The Start menu can also be resized by primary clicking on its edges and dragging it into position. Don't forget to keep the mouse button held down while you drag, and letting the button go when you've gotten the edge in the position you want. However, a lot of people do not like the tiles even existing in the Start menu at all. To remove the tiles, secondary click on each one and select Unpin from Start menu. Don't worry, this will only remove the tile from the right section of the Start menu and will not uninstall the programs. Once the Start menu is closed and opened again, the entire right panel will be gone. The middle panel of the Start menu provides an alphanumeric list of the apps you have installed on your device. By default, Windows also shows some other listings at the top, such as Most Used and Suggested Apps. By secondary clicking on one of the apps in this list, you can pin to the taskbar or pin to the Start menu. Pinning to the Start menu will restore the right panel. This is also how you add app tiles to the right panel. Sometimes you can also drag tiles from the right panel to the desktop or taskbar, although this won't work for every tile. Moving on to the left panel, clicking on the three-line icon on the top will show you the names of the icons at the bottom, which you can also discover by hovering your pointer over each one. We will be going over these options in future videos. By default, from top to bottom, they are Your Account, File Explorer, Settings, and Power. But we will take a moment to find the Start menu settings. Primary click the gear icon to open the settings and search Start menu. Here you can read the options and turn them off and on as you like. If you decide to change some of these settings, be sure to only do one at a time so that you know which setting you turned on or off in case you don't like the result. Thank you for watching this tutorial video provided by the Buffalo and Erie County Public Library.